whether my data is structured or clean at first? If not, how should I do it? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from Knowhow Academy. In this video, we will see a case study, then we will see what are the advantages of having inbuilt transformations in Power BI. Then we will look into the practical approach in understanding Power BI with inbuilt transformation. The case study, let us consider in this way. We all know that any data that we receive from the client or a customer, it is completely inappropriate. It is not structured. It is not clean. Then, if this kind of data is there with us, is it possible to create visuals? Is it possible to create reports or dashboards? Obviously, it is no. With the incomplete data, with the unclean data, it is not at all possible to create a proper report or dashboard. Let's walk into an example that I will tell it to you. I have a set of data set of sales and marketing. There are multiple columns and rows in it. So we have the data such as list price, unit price, and order quantity in it. And the client wants to see what are the total sales and what is the total profit from this particular data, as we don't have the sales and profit as a columns there. So how should we do that? There are two ways to do it. One, we can use obviously the DAX functions and get the result out of it. Number two, without writing any function, directly we can use inbuilt transformation and get some information out of it. So let us look into this data set that I will be showing it to you. I have a small data set of a product. So the inbuilt transformations that we have in Power BI is Power Query Editor, which is the inbuilt transformation, the highest advantage, the benefit that Power BI is having. That's why the Power BI is leading in the market. The Microsoft Power BI is leading in the market because we have, one of the reasons is because we have inbuilt transformation, which is Power Query Editor. So in this data, as I have told you, we have multiple columns here. And we have list price, unit price, order quantity. We have two empty informations in these two columns. Now, with the regular way, it is difficult or it takes multiple steps in order to remove the columns which is having errors or empty and do the transformations in it. If I talk about the other business intelligence tool that we have, let us consider Tableau, then we need to use other tool, use MS Excel or use any other technology tool, software. There you do the transformations, again load that data into Tableau, then start preparing the visuals. That is a multiple, there are multiple steps that are involved in it in order to do the transformations. But here in Power BI, we have this Power Query Editor, which is completely inbuilt. So if I would like to remove these two columns, I'll just select my two columns using Control key, right click and remove the columns. I will remove it in two steps. My two null columns are gone. But if I would like to go with MS Excel, there I have to remove these two again, save that particular Excel sheet. Again, I have to load it back. And that's the difficult way that we can do it. I cannot tell it as a difficult way. Yeah, it is easy, but it involves multiple steps to do it. That is the point that we have it there. So if I talk about the advantages, what are the different advantages that we have by Power Query Editor, with Power Query Editor that we have it inbuilt in Power BI? Number one, I can talk about, it is completely easy of use, very easy if you know the computer, if you have a knowledge of computer, and yes, if you can understand everything easily, Power Query Editor, you can do it very easy. So ease of use is the first one. Data cleaning part, you can perform multiple tasks such as, you know, removing the duplicates, filtering the information, removing the null values, identifying the errors, sorting it out. Data cleaning part is also very easy. And the third part that I would like to talk about is data integration. In Power Query Editor also, you can get the data from multiple data sources and integrate it with the existing data that you have it in Power BI, which is in Power Query Editor as well. And data modeling, and data modeling is also very, very, very important. Performance optimization plays a very crucial role. So performance optimization, if I talk about the performance of a report, performance of a dashboard, once when we prepare it, the time that it is taking in order to load the dashboard, so all these comes into the picture. So another point is data reusability. Now, transformations that we do, it can be saved as part of Power BI file, allowing you to reuse the same by, you know, by saving it as in a PBIX format, you know, for the same data preparation for future reports that you can use it. Again, you can reuse this one, okay? So we have integration with the DAX functions. DAX stands for data analysis expression. This same Power BI we can use DAX functions here. We can use M language. So what is the language that we use in Power Query Editor? If a question is being asked, we can talk about as M language. M stands for mashup language. So again, the important point that I can talk about the advantage here is that the data security part. So we have, you know, inbuilt transformation, which ensures that the data remains with the Power BI ecosystem, which can help to improve the data security, especially in regulated industries. Okay, and if I talk about the cost effectiveness, the Power BI is, you know, very, very, very lesser cost when compared to other BI tools and all. So these are all the multiple advantages that we have. Now, if I look into the practical approach with the example that I have given it to you, we have list price, unit price, and order quantity. Now my client wants to see what is my sales and what is my profit. So how to do this one? If I talk about the DAX, yes, we can take the new column there and we can multiply list price times order quantity, then find out sales. Again, you take the new column again. Again, you choose a new column name by multiplying new unit price times order quantity, you get the cost. Again, from that, you find out profit by again choosing a new column, profit equal to sales minus cost. It takes a lot of steps. So let us see how easily this can be done using Power Query Editor. So I have my list price column. I press the control key in order to choose my another column, order quantity. Okay, I go to add column. So under standards, I have multiply. Okay, I will multiply it and I got my particular sales. Just double click to it and I'll rename my column name to sales. Very easy, very easy. In the same way, if you'd like to find out the cost, then again, I have to choose my unit price column, control key with the order quantity, go to standard, click on multiply. We can easily get the cost. So if I double click on it, I'll go with the cost. Very simple. If I would like to find out the profit from it, obviously the formula is sales minus cost. I'll click on sales first, then cost next. I'll go to standard and I'll subtract it. I got my profit. Okay, we can convert it into percentage as well. What is the percentage of profit that we have got it into? So these kind of easy things that we can do it. You know, I have removed the columns earlier, very easy, just by one right click and remove the columns. In the same way, lot of transformations that we can do it in this Power BI. You know, we can change uppercase into lowercase. You know, we can even extract the information from one column into and split into different columns using delimiters. Okay, and we can write the DAX functions here itself. We have something called as custom column. Okay, where the same formula that I have implemented, list price times order quantity, we get the sales. We can do the same thing here. If I would like to say sales duplicate as a column name, then I have my list price, insert, then I will choose my multiply with the order quantity, insert, and I'll click on OK. I'll get my, you know, sales again. If you see the same value, we have 10199. So we can even have this custom column function here in order to use it. We even have a conditional column also. What is conditional column? For example, if my gender equal to male, then I should get a answer as some M, and if my gender equal to female, I need to get as answer as F, and if my sales is greater than 2000, then my output should I get as good sales. If my sales is lesser than 1000, I need to get as average sales. So these kind of if else statements also we can use in this one. Now we can join two tables, we can merge the columns, we can use append. So a lot of inbuilt transformations that we have in this Power Query Editor, which will be very helpful. Once you are done with this whole transformations under Power BI, which is Power Query Editor, we need to click on close and apply, where the transformations will be completed and that will be saved, and that will be saved in Power BI desktop, and we will try to load it. So once when I click on close and apply, all those changes, we will get it into this particular Power BI desktop. And here we have to start writing the DAX functions if required, depending upon the client's requirement. And we have to start the preparing of visuals or reports or or anything that whatever the client is requesting is. So we have a lot of advantages we have seen in inbuilt transformations in Power BI. So the inbuilt transformation that we have in Power BI, again I'm repeating, that is Power Query Editor. So as we have this inbuilt transformation part in Power BI, that's where the Microsoft product Power BI is leading in the market. So thank you for choosing Knowhow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.